Hey, welcome back to How to Read Your Brain Training Graphs in your Muse app. So let's start at the top of when you go into the app, you choose me. And when you choose me, you can go to your session history. So I went through my session history and I chose a short session that makes a good point to show you for right now. It's close to what would be an ideal map. It's not perfect, which is exactly what I wanted to show you. But first, let's start where you can see that I chose ocean and music. I like to pick the soundscapes that also include music, but it gives me something to focus on. The ocean's going to modulate based on how well your brain is regulated versus how much dysregulation there is. So that's going to be the difference between if your brain is wired and tired or moving towards calm focus. The more wired and tired, the choppier the ocean's going to be, the stormier. The more calm and focused, the lovelier the waves are going to be, and you're going to earn birds. They're going to chirp in your ears as a reward. That's the neurofeedback, feedback to your brain in the form of audio feedback. So the waves become calmer and you earn birds, the calmer and more focused your brain becomes. So this session I'm going to show you, and there'll be a graph of it below, you will see that the brain waves are pretty regulated and flat across the page. It's only 4 minutes. So you can see that they start in a pretty regulated mode and they go across. And you will see that they change if you look at them, and I'm going to show you how to analyze it. But essentially, this is basically what you're looking for: a low, flat, and calm brain pattern in the brain wave power bands. So let's go through this piece first. When we see brain wave power bands, that's going to include the 5 speeds that I taught you about in the last lesson. So first, when you open it up, you have to click the arrow and it will bring the brainwave power bands down so you can see them. All of them will be visible when they first show up, but then you can click on the different bandwidths and it will give you the individual brainwaves. So I'm clicking it back to all so I can show you what's happening. And again, this one will be below. I'll take it off in a second though. So what you can see is they are low and flat. Remember how I told you my job is to help you organize and stabilize your brain pattern? This is what an organized and stable brain pattern looks like. Pretty low, pretty flat across the page. And what it will equal is a higher percentage of calm. So looking at the brainwave power bands, you will see we have delta, extra slow speed. It is thankfully near the lowest on this graph. Theta is slow speed. It's down there with delta. So the slow speeds are not dominating my pattern. Next is gamma, and gamma is the extra fast speed. Like I told you, for the most part, it's going to be low on your graph. So delta and theta are very low because I was very fresh at this moment, and gamma's in the middle. Typically gamma will be the lowest. Then you can see next is beta. Beta is the fast speed of gassing. And on top of it on this graph is alpha. So for the duration of this session, my brain is in calm focus, which is exactly what we want your brain to be in. And throughout this program, I'm going to teach you in the 5 breakout sessions, I'm going to show you a graph for anxiety, attention issues, autoimmune disorders, arousal dysfunction, and internet addiction. So you are going to see examples of that. That's why I wanted to show you an example of a regulated brain here. Now, you can see how I can take it and I can make it show me just where delta is. So when we look at the next graph, the mind graph underneath it, you can see that when I stopped earning the birds, and it's hard to see on here, but you can see it below, when I stopped earning the birds as the reward, it's because delta spiked up. I had a little spike of tired. So my brain started to shut down on me a little, but then I pulled it back down and earned birds again. Then it tried to spike up again, but I pulled it back down based on the audio feedback. This is a workout for your brain. You don't have to try, but if you recognize that the birds have gone away, it does help to focus your mind. I'm going to teach you this in upcoming lessons. So then when we put delta or theta on, you can see delta was the culprit in spiking up to decrease my score. We take delta and theta off. You can see alpha's pretty flat across the screen. When we go over, you can see beta's nice and flat across the screen and gamma's nice and flat across the screen at the bottom. So this is how you interpret your brainwave power bands. Now let's go down to the next graph that is labeled mind. The mind meditation is neurofeedback. From my standpoint, that is the meditation that I want you to use as much as you can. I am going to teach you in the next lesson about a nervous system sync. That's what I call it when you use all the meditations in the Muse app to create a really nice synergy of brain, mind, and body. But for right now, this is neurofeedback. This is brain. This is the brain work, which is why the icon is a brain. So you can see that my brain started in the calm mode. On this graph, the dark purple, the lowest band there, is calm. In the middle, it's neutral. And up towards the top is an active mind. So an active mind doesn't reflect a common focus mind. What it reflects is a wired and tired mind. So when your graph in this mind graph, when it reflects the one line is up top, that active mind is something we want to bring down. So this is an ideal graph where the line goes across in the calm zone. It peaked a little into the neutral zone, but I told you that was from fatigue. It was 6 o'clock at night. How can you blame a girl, right? But you can see I've earned lots of birds, and you can see that when it comes back up, it never went into the active zone. If it goes up into the active zone and comes back down, you will earn a recovery. I will show you that in upcoming lessons. But for the most part, this is what we want you to achieve. 77% calm, achieving as many birds as you can, staying down in the calm, only peeking into the neutral a little, never hopefully, and not getting up into the active zone. This is the ideal graph that you are shooting for. Now there's a caveat. If you struggle with internet addiction, especially explicit matter, and if you struggle with arousal dysfunction, then you may have artificial neutral, artificial calm focus. I work with a lot of people who tell me, I have 99% calm. And I say to them, do you feel 99% calm? The answer is no. They have arousal dysfunction, they feel anxious, they feel tired and overwhelmed. It is artificial neutral. Alpha's dominating your pattern. You'll be able to see it up on the brain wave power bands. If alpha's really high and it's never coming down, that means you're stuck in alpha. That is not what you're looking for. That is at the root of your issues. If that's the case, you likely need a QEEG brain map with me, which is the assessment that I offer you, because there's more to it than just using this Muse headband. So take note of that, but in the meantime, try to get into focus more than calm when you're using the headband. And know if you're getting a 99% calm on this graph, you should feel 99% calm in your mind and your body. Neurological regulation, when it's healthy and authentic, it equals self-regulation. So that's what we're going for. Strong graphs of high percentages of calm that are flat, organized, and stabilized, and you feel that way in your mind and your body. Okay, follow me through to the next lesson on nervous system sync. I'll see you there.